My name is Everett Adams. I'm an account executive with Aquatic Informatics. And today I'm joined by Tom Urenka, who will be walking us through a demo. Tom.
Hey, everyone. Thanks for joining us. I'm going to show you how easy it is to do basic edits or not so basic edits using time series to your time series data. We're going to give you a quick presentation, show you, I'll scratch the surface a little bit on the kind of capabilities Aquarius time series has. Here's a site where I've selected stage time series, and I'm going to enter the data review tool. And you see here the time series shown here on the main screen. We have a timeline screen on the bottom. The data, as you can see, is kind of shown on the timeline screen. I can stretch or expand this any way I like. We have some gaps here. These little rubber boots represent field visits where you've gone into the field and taken measurements in the field. These circles here represent the data coming from those field visits. We can visit those as we want. And if I go to the main stage and I zoom in on an area, you can see now I have a zoom here and the timeline has shrunk. The two screens work together beautifully. We have a number of bands here, the approvals band. You can see this data is in review. This data here is approved, meaning it can no longer be edited unless some senior data scientist or whoever you've appointed unapproves it and allows you to edit it. Here we see some data grades. We don't have a defined data grade for HIS. Here we have a data grade, very good. And we have some other things here that we're going to look at a little bit later. But as we can see, we've got a problem here with this set of data. So let's zoom in on this problem and see what happens. All right. So we've got some sort of flutter. So we're going to go and fix that. So what we're going to do is select our edit tool, and we're going to select this area that we want to edit. When the edit tool is selected, you can see the edit types show up. So now we have a drop-down menu of a variety of things that we can do based on our best analysis of what's to be required. We can, for example, do adjustable trim, trim above and below the data set. We could delete this region. We could copy and paste from some other data set, or we could do what we're going to do, which is an override. And here we have more options where we could copy and paste from another data set, as I mentioned, or we could just draw a line. But we're going to do something called moving average filter, which will let the system do a little bit of work for us by selecting a line to say, you know, every 15 dots, every 15 data points, take a moving average, repeat that 50 times, and give me your best guess as to the line. And here's what the system has done. It's kind of given us a guess. We can now, as human beings, adjust it because we think, well, it's not perfect. I think we can get a better fit than that. And if we can want to, we can drag things down. Okay, we're pretty happy with that. So we're going to apply that correction and we see our new line. Now, we could have made it more perfect. I just didn't want to spend the time doing that. But as you can see, I think with a few more tweaks, we could have bumped it up. And indeed, that is something we can do even now. But I'm not going to do that. Do some other things instead. Here we see the raw data. We can turn off the raw data and see our correction. The system never deletes your raw data. It always keeps it. It's always available. All corrections are done on top of your raw data. You always have that for reference and for your record keeping. Okay, so we've done a little bit of a correction. Let's do something else. Let's change the data grade to whatever it is we think it's good. And these are all data grades that you can set. We're going to set it to estimation. We can put a comment if we like, fix data flutter, and we can apply that. And voila, we have a data grade of estimation for this region. We can also add what's called a qualifier, which again is something that you can define, easy shorthand to help people understand what's been done. You know, we had an equipment file function for the sake of argument. We can apply that, and now we have all of that there. What we also have is an edit history of what happened to this data. So here, draft, equipment malfunction, draft estimation, and correction draft. In each case, we have what we did, what date range was done to, when this edit was done, and who did it by myself. And this is available as a report as well, so you have full traceability of your changes. And now we can save the data, and we have that done. And if we expand back and maybe turn off that, we can see our new line. And you know, we can go now scan the line and see what other things we might want to fix. But that in a nutshell is how data is corrected. Here, for example, we see offset error, and sure enough, there's tools for offset errors as well. I could likewise settle, grab this region here, do another correction here using offsets, very easy, edit type offset, and I can just go and lift the data up, apply, here I go there, and I missed a point there, and I'll fix that later away from this video, because I'm just kind of working quickly to show you the sort of things that we can do quickly in time series. So that's it. That's a very brief introduction to the power of Aquarius time series and editing data. And I hope you enjoyed this little presentation. Everett?
Yeah, thank you for joining us today. And if you would like to learn more, please reach out to myself or Tom. Thank you.